Well, good evening, everybody. So another run straight after school tonight. Still light, as you can see outside, so that was fine. It was on the road. I know. It was the same run I did last week in 26 minutes, which I did in 24:18 today, so a good 1 minute 40 better, which is interesting. I did feel looser. It was a lot easier. So that's encouraging. But what I wanted to talk about tonight was, I know that I've mentioned my journey back being slow and arduous and more comebacks than I wish to think about. One of the reasons I posted early on was I've got a condition called psoriatic arthritis, which is, it's like any arthritic condition, be quite debilitating. And I wanted to explain about how it came about and where I am in regard to that condition. So very early on in the sort of 90s, I was having a lot of joint pain, particularly shoulder pain, my right shoulder here, that I just disregarded as, you know, joint pain. I thought the shoulder pain was caused by lifting a trampoline up and down at school and so on. It gradually got worse, but by 2008, I was forced to go and see a surgeon, and a couple of cortisone injections, it didn't really help, to whereby in 2011, I had a shoulder operation for a foot down a frozen shoulder by a surgeon called Roger Hackney. Roger Hackney and myself was a good world-class athlete who now lives, works and Leeds, who I looked up to as a junior man going to world championships. He was running for Wales, I was running for Scotland. He was one of the athletes I aspired to sort of look up to. I think it was Wales, could be in England, I can't remember. Anyway, he operated on my shoulder, and for several months afterwards it was easier, but still couldn't get the shoulder, right arm above my shoulder, which was a worry. And the pain kept coming back, pains in my Achilles, pains in my knees, pains in my hips, pains in my back, shoulder and neck, and I couldn't really turn my neck, and I've still got a little bit of inflexibility in the neck joint. And I went back to see my GP, who then sent me to see a consultant orthopaedic in Otley. Straight away he said, you need to see a surgeon or a consultant on arthritis. I think you've got an arthritic condition. 6 months later, my appointment comes through, and I see a young man called Dr. Green at Harrogate Hospital. Revelation. Within minutes, he diagnosed psoriatic arthritis. He looked at the fingernails, he looked at the base of my back, and looked at the only patch of arthritis I really had on my shoulder, on my elbow. And he said, you've got psoriatic arthritis. This condition's been with you for a while. It's like psoriasis skin, except it attacks the joints. Not everybody with psoriasis gets it. People with psoriasis tend to be much more skin-based, but this is a condition we've picked up in the last so many years, and it is akin to rheumatoid arthritis. Not as bad, but it can be as debilitating if not treated. So the choice was to go onto a drug called methotrexate, which he told me about. Side effects weren't, it went great. I wasn't keen. It can have a lasting effect on the kidney and liver, taking in large doses. It is a drug for treating cancer, ostensibly. So I went away and thought about it. But in the meantime, it gave me a full-body steroid injection. I was like Bambi. For 4 or 5 months, I felt great. However, I got really bad acne on the face, on the back, which I didn't like. And I thought, bring back the pain. I don't like this. I look worse. I'd rather feel the pain. I'm back to see him in September and agreed to go on to the drug. And I've been on that drug ever since. I've been on the tablet format and now I'm on the self-injection format. The joint pain ostensibly is gone. I don't have it at all. A little bit of stiffness in the morning, but nothing compared to what I had. I mean, I couldn't walk. I struggled to walk. I was in pain every day. Running was a no-no. So, and really, the excuse I've had really since then is just late nights, you know, not being bothered, just laziness. But now, with very little pain in comparison, I can run again, and I want to run again. I want to get fit, really, to get rid of the gut and feel healthy. So the moral is, you know, you may have conditions that you don't know about. it does take a long time sometimes to get them diagnosed, but once diagnosed and treated, it does mean if it's successful, you can get back on the pathway to running successfully, which is what I'm doing now and which is making a big, big difference to me. Okay, so I'm going to be interviewing a colleague on Sunday, 10 questions, half hour interview about her running career, so look out for that. In the meantime, have a good weekend. Cheers, bye.